But despite his admonition to Quasimodo, Frollo himself could not stop thinking about her.
He began to walk the streets, night after night.
Unable to bring himself to return alone to his cold, dark chambers.
He barely knew what he was looking for, but he could not resist.
He thought he saw her everywhere.
Until one night, walking down an unknown alley,
he drew to the most unsavory part of the city,
passing lovers embracing in the shadows.
Dark of the night, in the dead of the winter, pleasure is fleeting, so lips will be meeting.
Time will be us,
come keep me warm until morning. Hey!
Rest and recreation. For my young friend Frederick here as well.
I'm sure that can be arranged.
Actually, I'm looking for someone in particular.
And why aren't I surprised? But I'm afraid she's already spoken for.
Oh, really, Clopin? Nobody speaks for me.
I'm only looking out for your own welfare.
I can look out for myself.
You lose friends easily, don't you?
I have that way about me.
Too bad. It makes seeing you that much more difficult.
And does that disappoint you?
Does that surprise you?
Frankly, yes.
Me too.
Well, now that you found me, what are you going to do about it?
I told you. I'm not as good as everybody likes to think.
In the dark of the night.
This vile depraved display.
In the dead of the winter.
I cannot bear to watch, and yet I cannot look away.
You'll keep me warm until morning.
Well, that was pleasant. For you too?
I have to go.
Why?
You're not the only one who needs to make a living.
Where can I find you?
In the dark of the night.
Morning.
I see her!
That isn't her.
I know, but I can't stop thinking I see her everywhere.
You're not supposed to think of her at all.
I can't help it. I miss her.
Quasimodo, you can think about whoever you want.
Master says I mustn't.
He can't tell you what to think and not think.
Besides, you look out there every night.
But this is different. Everything is different now.
So many times there, I watched a happy pair of lovers walking in the night. They had a kind glow around them. It almost looked like heaven's light. I knew I'd never know that warm and loving glow. Though I might wish with all my mind, no face hideous as my face was ever meant for heaven's light. But suddenly an angel with smiled at me and touched my face without a trace of fright. I dared dream that she might even care for me. And as I rang the bell tonight, my cold dark tower seemed so bright. I swear it must be heaven's light.